Chip. Hey, Chip, can you turn it on a little bit? A little bit more? Chip. Uh-huh. That's good. Hey, everybody get a seat in the front right there. Would you pull your chairs down, get your seat? Y'all move over this way. Did you have a good Easter? You can turn that down just a little bit if you want. Check. How many people come in on Saturday? How many people come in on Saturday? You did? One, two, three. Okay. Four. Good to have you with us. Five. That's good. You're good. What is that? Oh, you got a finger. Get you a seat, buddy. Did you come in on Saturday? I've never seen you before.
Hello, Cam. Good morning.
Get you a seat. Yeah. Welcome to Honky Tonk School. My name's Scott Collier. I'm the assistant talent director for world famous Tootsie's Orchid Lounge, Rippy's, Honky Tonk Central, Kid Rock's Big Ass Honky Tonk, every place in our circuit. Old Hickory Country Club, Pace Ford Marina, Sligo Marina, all of it. It's a lot, it's a big one. My boss, John Taylor, your boss, he served for your freedom in the United States Marine Corps of Vietnam. He created Honky Tonk School. I'm his assistant. I help him out with whatever he needs. I'll give you a brief rundown on a little history of our organization. 1992, Steve Smith, I named you the Honky Tonk Godfather because he saved Tootsie's. It was a very bad area. Lower Broadway is nothing like it is now. It was so bad, matter of fact, that the city was going to tear Tootsie's down, it would have been lost forever. There was a lot of drugs, a lot of prostitution, a lot of homeless, a lot of bad people down here, right? Steve wouldn't let that happen. He was afraid that the city was going to tear Tootsie's down and it would have been lost forever. He got a Lazy Boy recliner and camped out in a world famous front room for 3 months. At this time, Uncle John was, we call him Uncle John, he was down in Florida. When Uncle John got back from Vietnam, he wanted to work on Wall Street. He wanted to be a stockbroker. He was business-minded, one of the smartest guys I ever met. He ended up moving to New York. He got a job on Wall Street and became very successful. So successful that he always loved music. You know, music was always his passion. It was his therapy. Music saves people. He opened up a nightclub in New York. He had a roller skating rink on one floor and a discotheque on the other floor. Now imagine that, being back in the 70s, walking into a place like that. I would have loved to have seen it. His house bands that he had, Chaka Khan was one of his house bands. How many people know who Chaka Khan is? Y'all know that? Yeah, good music. The other house band was Prince. So he knew music, right? And his brother Steve Smith knew that Uncle John knew music. So when Uncle John got done on Wall Street, he moved to Florida, and he was down in Florida. And Steve called Uncle John up and said, "Brother," he said, "I need help getting Tootsie's. I need help rebuilding the city, getting Tootsie's back on top." And Uncle John told Steve, he said, "If you get the rights to Tootsie's, I'll be up and help you." Well, Steve camped out for 3 months in that world famous front room, finally got Tootsie's declared a historical landmark where the city couldn't touch it. And that's why we're here, right here, two guys. And Al Ross. Al Ross helped out a lot. So they went back and they rebuilt the city. And I remember seeing an interview with an artist. I can't remember what artist it was, but I remember seeing this interview where the artist said, "The last person to leave Nashville shut the light out." They were going to move all the music to Branson, Missouri. I personally witnessed some of this because I come down. My parents, it's my mom, she came down to visit me. She, family, family thing. But they took me and my sister down here whenever we were kids, and I remember seeing plywood on the windows of the Ryman Auditorium. You know, they were literally going to shut the music down. Thank God for Steve Smith and Uncle John Taylor. We'd be in Branson, Missouri right now. I played music most of my life, like all of us have. I'm from Ohio, is where I'm from. Chillicothe, Ohio is where I'm from. I played a lot in Columbus and a lot around the surrounding cities, and thought that I knew a lot about music until I moved here. When I moved here, it was a reality check, because back home I was a big fish in a small pond. When I moved here, there was a lot of fish. There's a lot of big fish. So it took some learning, and Uncle John helped me out a lot on learning music and learning what songs to play, what songs not to play. And then he taught me something about the business, and I wanted to learn that side of it. Like I said, I played a lot in Ohio. There was a place called Austin City Saloon. I don't know if y'all ever heard of it or not. It was in Lexington, Kentucky. And John Michael Montgomery had just got signed out of there, so I knew that there was people coming up from Nashville, and they were signing people out of that bar. So I made it a point, every time my band was out off for the weekend, I would go to Lexington, Kentucky, and go to Austin City and just hang out. And that's where I run into Troy Gentry from the group Montgomery Gentry. We become friends, and I remember when Montgomery Gentry started getting real famous, they were opening up for Kenny Chesney in Columbus, Ohio, Polaris Amphitheater. I was driving a dump truck hauling asphalt and gravel and dirt and all that stuff. And I had an old phone. I can't remember if it was a flip phone or a bag phone. It's been a long time ago, but I had this phone in my truck, and it went off, and it was a 615 number. And I'm like, oh, I better answer that. So, man, I grabbed it, and I answered it, and it was Jemma Moniak from Montgomery Gentry, their guitar player. And he said, hey, he said, we're playing tonight. We're opening up for Kenny Chesney. Do you want to come to the concert? And I said, yeah. I said, he said, well, go pick your will call tickets up. Hell, I didn't even know what will call tickets was. I've never been around anything like that. He said, yeah, you just show them your driver's license, and they'll get your passes, and you can go backstage. I walked up there and handed them my driver's license, and they gave me my passes and stuff. And man, I'm walking right past security, and they're like, come in. And I got back there, and that moment changed my life. I started seeing all those tour buses and stuff, and as soon as I got back to the Jim Beam bus, which was the bus that the band rode on, the Montgomery Gentry band rode on, I saw T-Roy and Troy come out, and it's like, come on, get on the bus. Man, I got on there, and I was hanging out with them, and they went out, and they did their show. When they got done with their show, I walked up to Eddie and Troy. They were standing off to the side, and I said, man, I said, how do I get into this? Eddie looked at me, and he said, go down to Tootsie's, get your job. I know those people down there. You know, that's how you start. Go to Tootsie's. And, man, that moment changed my life. I took him up on that offer. I come down and moved a couple years later, and been there ever since. Been there since, I don't know, it's going on 20 years now. I mean, time flies, don't it? It feels to me like I've been in town for about 5 years. But, I mean, it goes quick. Once you get in the mix down here and you're starting to work and you're starting to do all these shows and stuff and then doing some out-of-town stuff and you're traveling and, you know, time just goes by. It just goes by fast. Music has been a great provider for me and my family. I've been able to buy a house. I've been able to raise 2 kids. You know, now I help my grandkids and all that stuff. So, you know, you guys are in a good seat. You got a good opportunity. My thing, I was always the yes guy. I was always Uncle John's yes guy. Anything Uncle John would ask me to do, if it was in my power, I'd say yes. There's a lot of times I've been down here on the street and, you know, work a morning shift or an afternoon shift, and Uncle John called me up, hey, I need you to do a 6 to 10, or I need you to do a 10 to close, and I was always that guy that said, yes, I'll be there. Never turned him down that I can remember. But I moved here to work, you know. I moved here to build something. I didn't realize that I was doing that. I had no idea. I just showed up for work every day and doing my stuff. And I always tried to make sure I show up on time. That's a big thing. You know, make sure that your band and you guys show up on time and dressing nice and looking good. One of the things that Uncle John always taught us too was go down and watch these bands that are doing it. You know, go down and watch Anita's band. Come down and watch my band, John Stone, Mance Brothers, Hippies and Cowboys. You know, come down and watch some of our top bands that's doing it. And take a notebook with you. Write down what songs are playing. Write down what songs are working. And, you know, put that into your mix. And, you know, it takes a lot of work. It does a lot of work to build a band, to build a great band. And then you go into rehearsal, like Zach's been doing. Zach's got a new band coming out of the chute. And he's been in rehearsal. He was in rehearsal yesterday on Easter. He called me up and, you know, said, hey, we're coming for you. I can't wait to hear your band, buddy. You know, it's all about working. The first artist that I was able to train, Uncle John called me up one day and he said, I got this kid from Missouri coming in. He said, I want you to train him. I'll never forget it. I was on the front stage of Tootsie's and this kid walks in and he looks at me and he has his notepad and all this stuff. And he looks up at me and he said, are you Scott Collier? I said, yes. He said, my name's Tyler Farr. I said, nice to meet you. He said, can I sing a song? I said, yeah. He gets up and sings, and he's a pretty good singer, but he was a songwriter. He reminded me of, you ever watch that movie, 8 Mile, Eminem, where he writes down all those lyrics, and that was Tyler. Tyler slept with that thing, man. I mean, he was always, if he was in the passenger side of my pickup truck, he was over there writing. He was just writing and writing and writing. It's paid off for him. I mean, he's had 3 number ones on Sony and toured with Jason Aldean for 2 years. So, you know, he's a worker. You know, he worked hard to get where he's at, and I'm proud of him. You know, we brought him in, and I helped him, you know, get his band together and all that. And then he started working at Tootsie's, and, you know, the rest is country music history. Tyler was never one of those guys that slept till noon. He was a guy that got up early in the morning and got his stuff done, you know. He's over there polishing his guitar, putting new strings on his guitar, you know. He'd wake up in the morning and he'd be sitting on the couch writing a song. Or, you know, he was a go-getter. And that's what it takes. It takes that, you know, and it pays off. We're running a little bit behind today. I'm going to bring John Mazzella up. Honky Tonk School opened up a new studio that we're very proud of. Got on top of the line gear. He'll talk to you about it. This is John Mazzella, everybody.
What's going on, guys? So we do have a fully functional recording studio now. It's actually located at Uncle John's property. We've got an all-analog signal chain, got a bunch of good outboard gear, and we're offering single packages for pretty competitive rates. Has anybody here recorded a single using somebody else's band from the studio? We know that some of those can run. Have you? What did you pay for it? If you don't mind me asking. What's that?
I actually had a friend pay for it for me.
So oh, good. We all need a friend like that. Well, the point being that you can pay as much as, somebody said $3,500 one time. More commonly, you can find a solo producer for like $500 and he'll play all the instruments. But you don't get that live band thing. So one thing that we're offering is you get to use the live bands that actually are best on the street. I've got Rod Jansen and his trio on board, and I've also got Dave Olson and his trio. So But even more than that, guys, even more than just the recording studio thing, who here has been on American Idol, The Voice, America's Got Talent? Well, who here has seen those shows, right? One of the things that they do best is actually to tell the artist's story. So, you know, you'll get a scene where they'll be giving an interview telling the story about their first gig, where they're from, who inspired them. And one of the things that we're offering now is content packages. So if you want to come to the studio, we've got a green screen, and we've got a space where you can pretty much do a couple of acoustic songs and then tell your story with professional interview lighting. So imagine that you're telling your story and it's flashing on the screen behind you. Everything's done kind of like a Barbara Walters interview, you know? So if you're interested in any of that, scan the code before you leave. Sarah has got the code right here. So thank you very much.
Yeah.
I'm Zill.
I'm gonna bring Anita up real quick, and then we're gonna start making some music. All right. Anita, she helps a lot. She's a big part of what we do. She's got an awesome band. She's an awesome drummer. She helps us do the me and her do the booking together, and she's my psychiatrist, my best friend. Anita Hill.
Thank you, Scott Collier. Did you come back last night or this morning?
Last night.
Yeah, he's a hoss, man. He'll drive and get in. How much sleep did you get?
Oh, I don't know.
Not much, right?
It's pretty good. I slept
pretty good. He's been known to drive and get very little sleep and still show up and do the deal. So, yeah, that's awesome. And that's a model for all of us, right? Just to dress up, get up, dress up, show up, whether you feel like it or not. And you will feel like it. Once you get there and put the smile on your face, you will feel like it. Hi, Brownie. So, yeah, so dress up. It should be a major part of what we do is how we dress. We want to look like rock stars. We want to look like the coolest person in the room. Because if we invest in ourselves, then they will invest in us. And this is also, a Honky Tonk school is also a really good opportunity to make fans for the rest of your life. Because when you really connect with people, they'll follow you. They'll believe in you, they'll follow you. They love to be a part of your journey to see where you started and how you know, how far you go with it. So, and connecting can be eye contact. You know, look, even just looking, when they come in the room, notice them. Ask them where they're from. Smiling. Give me something else. How to connect with the crowd.
Yeah, ask them questions.
Where are you from? Yep.
Yeah, what song
do
you want to hear?
Yep. Absolutely.
Yeah,
also
place
we have. Oh, I know you. That's why I called him. He's awesome. Yeah, so in reading, there's a new trending on LinkedIn, there's a new trending skill set of reading social cues. Is that on all y'all's radar? Does anybody know about that, or have you thought about that much? Yes? Yeah. So how to read, and there's positive social cues and also negative social cues. So when you're reading a room, you know, the positive is awesome. That means you're doing the right thing. So it might be like nodding, it might be leaning in. Eye contact, being interested. You want them interested. The kiss of death is to be boring. Whatever you do, do not be boring. So whether that be moving around, talking to them, you cannot be boring. At all costs, you cannot be boring. So reading social cues. Negative social cues might be somebody that's on their phone or crossing their arms and leaning back. What else? Mike, do you have another, like, no eye contact?
Walking out.
What's that?
Talking with your friends and not listening.
Yeah, talking, not listening. Yeah. And how would you, does anybody have any ideas of how to handle that?
Keep doing your thing.
Keep doing your thing? Anybody else? Thomas.
If you know their name or where they're from, you just call them out. You're
call them out.
Right there.
Absolutely. Call it out. Address it. How are you doing? Where are you from? And then all of a sudden they will be, you'll get their attention and you'll get them bought in.
Keep the show energetic, keep it moving.
Yes. Yes, you should think of it like a radio show. There shouldn't be a lot of dead space, a lot of dead time, because people will come up and either try to convince you you know a song that you don't know, and they'll even tell you, well, I've heard you do it, and you're like, well, no, you haven't. Yeah. Or just to take the time of the lead singer, and that's where teamwork makes the dream work steps in. Whoever's good at talking, jump in there and talk to the crowd. You cannot have that dead space. That is, there's so many places here and so much competition that you have to just be like a NASCAR pit crew, as Scott says, right? You have to think of it like a radio show. John.
Instead of trying to compel your less involved listeners, reward your involved listeners.
That's good. So how might you do that?
Praise them. We have a thing, this guy's the first dipper, so he's the coolest guy at the bar. We want to give it up for the coolest guy at the bar.
Awesome. Yep, rewarding good behavior. That's good. Anybody else have any ideas?
Sometimes when you know a little bit about the person, you could talk with substitute a lyric in a song for them specifically and make them feel special.
That's good, yeah. Everybody wants to be seen and heard and they want to feel special. They don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. I always say that, but it's so true. And they love the sound of their own name. People love to hear their own name. We all do. So that's a powerful thing. And if you don't know them, if there's a character, I always look for the characters.
They're always buddy to me.
Yep. You know that's going to be your tool to get the room, you know, just to get some entertainment out of it, right? Yeah. Do you want to talk about that, how you do that?
What's that?
How you find, if there's somebody that looks mad or not, looks like they're grumpy or they're furrowed brows.
Oh, I pick out the hardest guy in the room. Like a lot of times, like for instance, the other day I was on Kid Rock main stage and there's this dude up there with his wife and a big old burly guy and beard, you know, and he's looking at me like that. And I make it a point to put a smile on that dude's face. Like there might be 500, 600, 700 people down there, but I pinpoint one and I make out a call. Like I knew that I was going into a Johnny Cash song, so I went, how many people's ever been to jail in here? Like that. And then I look up and I said, well, my buddy up here just got out of jail this morning, you know, the biggest burly guy in there. And he's like that's how I do it. I just pick on people. I just have fun. That's what you're supposed to do. That's you're an entertainer, you know. Yes, Zach.
My two favorite things that you do on stage.
Yeah.
One of them is, where's all the happy people at?
Oh, yeah, happy people, yep.
You saw Sammy Hagar do that.
Yeah, Sammy Hagar did that, yep.
And the other one that you do that I absolutely love is, I want you to turn to your neighbor. If you don't know your neighbor, give them a high five like you mean it.
Yeah, I got that from church. It's true. Everything I've done, I've stole from somebody pretty much, you know. I always told Tyler back in the day, I said, man, take three of your favorite artists, put them together, and that's who you are. I said, who's your three favorite people? They don't have to be singers, actors, whatever. They can be whatever you want. He said, well, he said, I like George Jones. I said, boy, everybody does. I love George Jones. He said, I like Hank Jr. because he's an outlaw. And he said, I like Michael Waddell. And I said, who's Michael Waddell? And he said, he owns a hunting show. Does a hunting show. So that's how Tyler become to wearing camouflage pants and all that stuff, you know. And you can hear the outlaw in his voice, and you can hear the George Jones smooth techniques in his voice if you really listen. He blended all three of those artists together, and that's who you are. You take three of your favorite, put them together, get on YouTube, it's all there. Watch them live, you know, watch their live concerts. Ever since Toby Keith passed away, every night I've been, you know, watching Toby. God, I forgot how great of an artist he is. I forgot how great of a singer he is. I forgot how great of a songwriter he was, you know? I mean, Toby speaks to me, you know? Like, I love his show, and just like how he brings the troops on stage with him and flies the American flag and stuff, you know, very patriotic. And people love that, man. Like, I watch hippies and cowboys. They bring an American flag with them every time, and they set it on stage. And it's just like, you know, right now we need that. We need that. You know, they got their fog machines and they got all that stuff going too. But, you know, it's like if you look up there and you see that American flag flying, it just does something to me. You know, it really does. Different techniques of your show to make it different, you know. Tommy Barnes wrote Indian Outlaw and My Love for Little Texas and wrote a bunch of songs. He's one of my buddies. We've been friends ever since I moved to town. And he always asked me, he said, did you move to town to fit in or stand out? That always stuck in my mind. Stand out, you know. Make it your own. You know? That's what I've always tried to do.
And you're talking about Toby Keith. Toby was extremely persevering. Does everybody know that? He got turned down. They said his songs were no good. Yeah. All of them. Like by, I don't know how many labels or whatever, but like he got major rejection. And they just be gone with you. And look at him. Look at where he ended up. Yeah. He persevered. He believed in himself and he persevered. He didn't give up with criticism. And criticism from not just your peers, but from, you know, the big dogs, so.
He said
in an interview, he said that he never took any time off until he got sick. You know, he said all the other guys, he said they'd be over there and they'd come out with a song and then they'd chill their heels for a couple years. You know, Toby said, man, he said, I just kept coming with hits. You know, he said, I kept working and kept coming with hits. He never stopped. You know, his band was always top notch. I know a lot of the guys in his band. Josh Bertrand played steel guitar for him. I know him. We played together in Ohio before he even got the Toby Keith gig, you know. So I knew what caliber little Josh was. You know, he's a monster on steel guitar. And then Dink Cook and, you know, was the bass player around town. And Dave McAfee, all those guys, man, that's freaking badass. You know, Toby hired badass musicians. That's what he did.
Did you give Abby Kay a shout out?
Oh, I'm getting ready to. You're reading my mind. No, that's what I was gonna do. No, that's what. Come here, Abby. Come here. Iron Maiden.
Hell yeah.
This girl blew my mind. She blew my mind on Thursday. I think it was either Tuesday. We were setting up to play Kid Rock main stage. My bass player looked at me and he said, I gotta go. He had his stuff all set up and everything. He's like, I gotta go. I said, why is that? He said, I gotta go to the hospital. He had bad health stuff going on. So he left and we played for the first hour without a bass player. And then we called up one of our buddies to come down and fill in. And he ended up filling in. And then the next day, I was going to get him back. Pat Lassiter's his name. Pat played for Charlie Daniels and Tracy Lawrence and all those. Pat knows all of our stuff, you know. And he always does a good job. So I asked Pat, I said, can you play on Thursday? And Pat's like, no, he said, I got stuff I gotta do, it's recording sessions or something. And I thought, man, I'm gonna give this young lady a shot in my band, right? I'm gonna give her a shot. And I remember the night before, Will Dowdy, my keyboard player, he called me up and he said, Scott, she's young. She ain't gonna know all these songs that we're doing, you know, because we do songs that's like 40 years old, you know. A lot of the 80s rock stuff and Motley Crue and the Van Halens and all the big songs from that era, we do. And I called Abby up. She's like, I got this. Well, she did too. She got it. Knew every song. Never made not one mistake. Right, and she's not lazy. She sang harmony behind me the whole time. That's one thing, you know, you get a great musician and then they lack off and don't sing harmony behind you, right? Harmony is a big part of what we do. I mean, it's just as important as anything, in my opinion, you know. And she got right up on the mic, man, and checked it, and I heard her in my ears, and just one heck of a job. She did awesome. I'm very proud of her. She's a go-getter. She reminds me a lot of like Tyler Farr was, because she called me up, God, what was it, about 6 or 8 months ago, or however long ago it was. She's like, I want to build an all-girl band. I said, okay, I'm with you. What she did, she started researching and started going around and auditioning people, and next thing you know, she called me up and she said, I got an all-girl band. She started rehearsing up here to tables and chairs. I walked up and heard her, and I'm like, holy shit, yeah, she built a hell of a band. For being 21 years old and having, and she's here today. I mean, like, she don't play. She's a professional. Thank you, honey. And she does the TikTok a lot. She's a TikTok superstar. That's something we're going to talk about here in just a second, too. Abby Kay right there. Abby. She must have some good parents, too. You know, she must have good parents.
I do.
That trained her right, because she's got an Iron Maiden t-shirt on. I love Iron Maiden. You got anything else you want to say? You good? Hey, Anita Hill, everybody. Here's Sarah May, and we're going to get going. Sarah May does all our social media stuff. She does our TikTok and helps with the open mic auditions. And now she's learning fiddle and she's playing some acoustic. And this is Sarah May. She's going to talk to you about TikTok.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey,
how you doing?
How's everybody today? Yeah. What's going on, y'all? This is a great organization that really trains everybody to entertain, which is what we're here for. If they tell you something, listen, because they know what's up. Honky Tonk School, we started from zero on TikTok 2 years ago. Uncle John was the one who said, get a TikTok. He's a really smart person. So we started that thing, and we did a contest to get it up, you know, get the numbers up. We had a whole contest, and we've been posting ever since. And y'all, the thing is just consistency, good quality content. Follow the people that are really posting good stuff. Abby Kay, everybody follow Abby Kay to shout out her even more, but she's got the profile. Her TikTok's blown up. I would say if you are just starting on TikTok, make a really good quality video and then promote it so you get to 1,000 and then go live as much as possible every single day. But make sure it's entertaining. Ways that Honky Tonk School can help you guys is a tag on Instagram your stories and we'll repost, you know, make collaborative posts and we'll try to get you if it's something good. So make sure on all the platforms, you know, you're tagging Honky Tonk School if it's associated with these bars. And we'll support you in that way. So that's the biggest thing I can tell you today, is how we can help you grow. So tag us and we'll tag you back. Cross audience sharing, that's the way. So thank you so much.
Yeah. I'll do a quick TikTok story and then I tell this every Monday and then we'll start playing music. TikTok is a real deal. It's a real thing. Those are real people. I know firsthand. She talked me into getting TikTok. I ended up putting it on my phone. And like I had Instagram and all the social media platforms. And I'm like, this TikTok thing is just, in my mind, I thought this is just another way, you know, whatever. I didn't think it was that big of a deal. So I downloaded it on my phone. I'm on Kid Rock main stage. There's this lady that comes in and she's a little different. She's dancing and stuff. And she put her Marlboro ultralights up on the stage by my feet, you know. And I thought, well, hell, I'm going to shoot a video on her. I didn't know how to hashtag anybody. I didn't know anything about it. I just went and did like a 20-second video of her dancing. That was it. Set my phone down, went back singing. By the time I got done with my gig, I had 500,000 views. I'm like, this is crazy. I got up the next day and I had like 1.5 million. I was like, wow, this is crazy. Tootsie's has a NASCAR. Me and my son was out at Nashville Motor Speedway and the Tootsie's car was going around the track. Uncle John called me up from Florida and he said, Scott, he said, that that lady that you shot a video on said she'd reach out to me. And I'm like, how in the world did she get your number? You know? He said, I don't know. He said, you better call her. So, man, I went and found me a quiet place, and I went off and I called that lady, and at this time it was sitting at like 3 million views. You know, just crazy. She answered the phone. She said, honey, she said, we didn't know that this thing was going to go viral. She said, but I've got a 15-year-old son that goes to school, and kids are making fun of him because of this video. And she said, can you delete the bad comments? Well, I started looking, and there was thousands of comments, you know, but it told me one thing, that those are real people. Those ain't made up. Those are real people that's on TikTok, you know. So one video, like I said, I never even hashtag nobody. I didn't know how to do it at that time. One video can just turn everything around. Now, I don't know how many followers I got now, a lot, just because of that one video. But, you know, keep posting, because the record labels and all that stuff, they look at your social media. That's a big deal. That's a big part of what we do. All right, do we have any full bands today? Full bands. You guys, how many full bands do we have? You got everybody from your band here? I can't hear,
honey. She's playing a gig right now.
Oh, okay. You're just missing Molly.
Yeah.
Okay. You're a full band?
We're only missing the bass player and like our guitarist. Our lead guitarist got in a car accident this morning, so
it's not good. Oh, wow. Sorry about that. Oh, is he okay?
Yeah, he's good.
Okay. But let's start this. Drummers. Where's the drummers at? Drummers. Who brought their gear? You brought your gear? I've never seen you play before. Have I?
I don't think so.
Okay, bring your stuff up and set it up right there. And then we'll run drum. Bass players? You got your bass player, Brownie? You got your bass?
No, I don't have a bass.
You don't? Come up and play some bass real quick. Lead guitar players? Did you bring your guitar and your amp and all that? Come on, I've not heard you play. Singers? You're a singer?
Yeah.
We're gonna try you first, because I've never heard you before. Come on up. Y'all take this time and talk amongst each other and all that stuff. Yes, ma'am, you'll have to come up here because I can't hear. You'll have to come up here because I can't hear. And then we're gonna start making music. Absolutely, where's your keyboard at? Get it, set it up right here.
What up, fool? How you doing, buddy? Alright. Nathan, what up, buddy? What you doing, Nathan? Hello, LB. Hello, Elizabeth. Hello, Jacob. Watching 404 Scott. What up, Slade? What up, Charlene? How you guys doing? Hope you guys had a good Easter. On the YouTube wall, Honky Tonk School. Judge John, why you do this? This is Honky Tonk School. Those are the future stars of tomorrow. They audition Saturday, now they're here today to audition in front of Scott Collier. Hello everybody, good to see you guys. I'm about to go downstairs and get some food. I'll be back.
Saxophone.
That's good, LB.
My name is Abby Kay. I play bass. I saw a couple people that joined just now that are always on my live stream. So hello, welcome, and have a great time listening to great music. These are all like new musicians that just recently moved to Nashville and are trying to get a gig. I come here because I try to convince them to let me play bass for them so I can get more gigs. Okay, love you.
My candidates are gonna, like, one day I'm just gonna release a bunch of, like, the funny pictures I get, and everybody's gonna look funny.
They can hear you, Rowdy. P. Diddy, we're jumping. We love you.
Yeah. check. You want me to like hit it? Show you how much I got? Alright, I got you. How y'all doing out there, Kid Rocks? Y'all look pretty good, smiling. Let me hear you make some noise. It's a party tonight. Let's get school started off right. And it's only in the morning. And it's only in the morning.
Check 1, 2, 2, 2, 2. Yeah. Oh, 1, 2.
Check, 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 1, 2. Check, 1, 2, 3. Pop, pop, pop. Check 1, 2. Okay, thank you.
That's a bag of
take that. Alright, take that. Can y'all hear me? How y'all doing on YouTube? Good morning. Hello, Wellington. What you guys think?
You cut him off right on the lead.
Yeah.
He was getting ready to go into that big lead thing, and you cut him off, and he. Yeah. Yeah. Don't cut him off. You're a badass guitar player. Sounds great. Give it up for him. He's awesome. How old are you?
23.
23. How old are you? 27. Wow. Damn. How old are you? 28. How old are you? 19. How old are you?
I'm 27.
Wow. Y'all young. Dude, you got a big future ahead of you. Play me some Kid Rock.
Play me some Kid Rock. We're Kid Rocks. We're gonna play some Kid Rock. Yeah. Don't know any Kid Rock?
I know from nature. I think.
That's it?
Who knows Kid Rock in here? Anybody know any Kid Rock stuff? I mean, we're at Kid Rock's big ass honky tonk. Right?
Okay.
You gotta learn some Kid Rock. Okay, that's why we're here. That's what we're doing. Play me one more.
You wanna do the Stone songs? Or do y'all. Honky Tonk Women? Alright, well, ain't Kid Rock for you, but we do a little Honky Tonk Women for you by the Rolling Stones. How's that sound?
What are you?
singer.
Where's the other singers at? Who come in on Saturday? Singers that come in on Saturday. Did you? Come sing. I want to hear you sing. Come on. Sing.
Wow. Yeah, you picked up.
Check, check. That's good for me, right?
Thank you.
entertainment wise, always look out your crowd and all that stuff, right?
Yeah. I've not really ever sang very much without a guitar, so this is a first for me.
Well, grab a guitar.
Yeah. All right.
Grab a guitar.
That was a fun experiment.
That's good. All right, I need another singer. He's going to play guitar. You got your guitar? Let's see. No more singers? Come on. You're bad at the bone, dude.
Bad at the bone.
And like the same set of his hymn, just... It's
good.
What about Zach on the saxophone?
Yeah! What's Zach?
I play some Earth, Wind, and Fire here. What's your name?
Mia.
What is it?
Mia Nitchi.
Manichi? Man. Mia Nitchi. I've never heard a name like that. Where are you from?
I'm from Greenville, South Carolina.
Mia Nitchi. That's pretty awesome. What song are you going to sing? Mom's Broken Heart. All right. Do you know that, buddy? Do you know that song? Do you know Mama's Broken Heart? Two chords? All right.
That I just posted, and you like the crap out of it, okay? That's what you gotta do today.
Don't say crap.
All right. Yes, yeah, she is.
Thank you.
everybody's heard that song. It's in our DNA. We grew up in that song, so you're gonna have to learn that song. No for no, like the lead goes. Come talk to me.
Okay.
Come
awesome.
Talk to me. Okay. Are you in the? Is your bass player here?
No.
Okay. All right. I'll bring you. Go back with your band, and I'll bring you up. Okay. Yeah. I need another drummer. Who's the other? Okay. Come on up. Hi, Macy. How you doing? Huh? Yeah. Come on up.
Tell the people where they can find you, your name, and
Hi, I'm Mia Nitchie. You can follow me on any social media platform, Mia Nitchie 9, at Mia Nitchie 9. It's M-I-A-N-I-T-S-C-H-E, and then the number 9. Follow me, give me likes, subscribe, all the things.
Max Field, come here. What song are you going to play?
Exactly. Real quick, man, talk to that
American
people, man.
Girl, do you know it?
Talk to that people. Zach Gilbert.
Guys, how are you? It's great to see you. Zach Gilbert here, Honky Tonk School.
You got a gun or something. All right, you good now. You good. Yeah, all right.
Oh, good.
Yeah. So you have a band?
Honky Tonk School, every Monday at 10 a.m. on Kid Rock's third floor. Z Pierre behind the camera streaming. Go give him a follow. Give his new accounts a follow. Make sure you're up to date with where he's going, where he's coming to. All right, y'all?
Shout out to Zach Gilbert, man.
Thank you guys very much.
They love you, man. Who was it? Right. I forgot what night. You was playing with Dean James. You were killing it. Was it Friday or Thursday?
I was here on Saturday.
Saturday. Guy on the sack is killing it. Zach, I love you, man.
Yeah, you're the best, man.
Happy to be here, man. Thanks for you, man.
Check. All right.
Check.
You doing okay, Mom?
check.
What did I just do? What under the thing? It's like.
Check. 1, 2, that's good.
Changing out like a NASCAR pit crew.
Zach, I love that shirt, man. That's sick.
Yeah, like it. It's one of my favorite bands of all time.
Queen, yeah, that's sick.
Yeah. Like more than Bohemian Rhapsody, more than We Are the Champions, We Are Rocky, all that stuff. Like, when you really listen to their discography, they were such a unique and such an awe-inspiring band.
You know your stuff.
Yeah. They just did things that nobody else thought to do.
What's they come out from the other bands and what's they come out like? You say, yeah, like, you know what?
Okay.
What?
Obviously, you have Freddie Mercury fronting the band.
Okay.
The guy walks into an arena full of not cool bands, and he has them in the palm of his hand talking about Live Aid.
Wow.
Live Aid in 1985. That's a crowd of music fans, not just Queen fans. That guy walks into the room with a rough voice and makes the entire stadium his
man, band. Legend. That's amazing.
Brian May, he made his guitar when he was 13 years old. The guitar he still plays today.
He made it.
This was a band full of not just kids from the neighborhood who just picked up instruments and just went clang. These were sonic geniuses. Sonically, harmonically, aesthetically, they were a step above. Yes.
All right.
She was just. Is that the legend that played with Wine?
Yeah, I love it.
Who you play with?
Let's hear it.
I play Randy Hammond.
Yeah, Randy Hammond. Yeah. That's the legend. Okay, cool, man. That's cool, man.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, I saw him a few times. I was like, oh my God, that's him.
What's your name?
Pierre. Yeah, it's Pierre. Baby, we're making love all night.
you want to ask? Amazing.
I need a singer. Anybody? Singer.
Give it up for the Jomo.
Beautiful. No, let's see how you progress. No, I need a keyboard player. Cool. What song are you going to sing?
Go, Abby. Remember us when you blow up. Remember me when you blow up. I'm like, Abby.
Hang on just a second. Hang on just a second.
Shortly. Follow me on TikTok, YouTube, ZPL519. Hello, me, Jen. What up, Nathan? What you doing, Nathan? That's my full-time deal right there.
Can we get the keyboard player up here?
do one more?
Yeah. That's mine. I know what it felt like. I printed this out. Do another one. He just said that.
Thank you.
Yeah, he doesn't come back here. Yeah. 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 What up, Scott? Say something to the people, man.
Hello, people.
Shout out to Scott Correa. He's amazing.
Come to Honky Tonk School. All you people out there all over the world that's looking to make a living at what you love to do, see us. Come to Honky Tonk School.
Yes, sir. Scott Gilbert back in the camera.
What Scott Collier neglects to mention is we have two of the greatest bosses in the world, John Taylor and Scott Collier himself.
And Steve Smith.
Shout out to Uncle John.
I forgot about the best boss, the big boss, the godfather himself, Steve Smith.
Shout out to Steve Smith, Uncle John.
Shout out Anita Hill, too.
Anita Hill.
Guys.
Shout out to Zach's new haircut that he got.
Yeah. Guys. This is just one big family. You come here, you get to have access to all these people who are willing to help you, who are willing to do anything to make sure that you're getting done what you need to get done. That's what this is about. It's a family. So come join our family.
Come join the Honky Tonk School family, guys. Yep. Me, myself, I'm happy to be here. I need to get 1,000 likes eventually. Well, I mean followers, 1,000 followers eventually.
I play keyboard down here, about ready to rock it.
Hey, tell,
tell them your social where they can find you.
At Max underscore Beal.
Yeah, Max Beal. Yeah, man, my bad, boy. I know you, man.
Hit me up. Check out my shoes, too. Come to Nashville. Not right now.
Oh, not right now. Okay,
I got the dudes on right now.
Okay, okay, not right now.
At night on the stage. I play Friday, Saturday night, closers on Rippy's main stage. We're running for Congress, so come check it out.
Shout out to Max Beal. My bad, bro.
Thanks for bearing with us, guys. Just take a minute.
Yo, shout out to Max Beal.
A minute. Monday, guys. It's been awesome having some loud music here so far. Everyone's been super awesome. My name's Pramuk. I've got a band behind me.
I'm Mia. You already heard me, but hi.
We're going to take it back to a classic country song, Take Me Home Country Roads, with John Denver. Here we go. Mountains and no river.
All right, cool. We're gonna do Dreams by Fleetwood Mac.
Feel good.
Yeah.
On Monday? Next week?
If this was like a paid gig or a paid concert and they was winning it from the phone, I probably would be, you know, be different.
Yeah.
Good to see you, Sandra. I have to move. So I'm sitting like right below the vent. I'll show you. So I'm like sitting right below this vent. And it's blowing like cold air on me. This is actually the best spot, you know. That way you guys can see.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, that's one we were working on through the week, so. Get there, we're getting those Kid Rock things, you know, at least one a week. Getting that thing going.
Yeah, just
let
me know.
All right. I was starting to cover it.
completely as a flat, then to B. So up.
Oh, okay, wait, so it's not just you press down.
Cool.
You know, you
have
to press down multiple things.
You have to press down multiple things to create.
I thought it was just you press down one fret.
No. We've got to have all this kind of finger coordination.
How many buttons do you have?
One. Well, there are endless combinations to what you can actually do on this thing. So technically, if I want to count all the buttons that I have, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 22 buttons.
You have 22 buttons.
Yes.
Do you use all of them?
Yes. Every point in the night, some key gets used because there's different combinations that you can use. Like there's three different ways to play this note right here. And also a fourth one. If you want to jump up the octave, there are other ways to play that note up there too.
Right.
That's C sharp. Nice. Cool. That's what concert C sharp is. Sorry, concert B. That's concert B, but C sharp on the saxophone is everything over. And if you press down this key, you get a jumpy octave.
So. So how long can you go without your throat hurting?
Anytime I want to. Well, it's not my throat I have to worry about, it's my lips.
Your lips?
Guys, you can tap it. No, it's different muscles.
You play the keyboard?
I lost count at 10.
Oh my God. Do you play, drum too?
Yeah.
Oh my God, you're a one man band.
I know.
Hey, I seen that on some Instagram somewhere, guys.
Sarah and I.
Like, give it up to Zach Gilbert.
I haven't sat down in so long.
Play with Dean James, killing it on the main stage. Zach, you've been on Honky Tonk School for... Zach, how long you been with Honky Tonk School?
Huh?
How long you been with Honky Tonk School?
2 years.
All right. Wow, for about 2 years.
Hello, Honky Tonk School. My name is Max Beal.
Hi, Max Beal.
Wait, say that again.
Go, Max. Hi, Honky Tonk School. My name is Max Beal. There we go. Thank you. On the drums, Abby K on the bass, Zach on the horn.
Cool.
Another one? Can we do Valerie and C? Yeah. Concert C. Abby K, you got it?
Didn't catch a chin. I hope you found the right man to
I want to send him out to country club one time. You know, get him, really blow it up.
So Maxville, he already played for Honky Tonk School. He had a house band, he played rookies. Sometimes Tootsies. Maxville, that was amazing, sir. Yo, Max, that was amazing, man.
Hey, thank you.
That was people love it, man.
Awesome.
That was.
Thank you. Man.
That was good, man.
Come to one of my shows, bro. I keep texting this man.
Yo. I got you, man. That was amazing, man. I got you, Max.
Awesome.
People love you, man.
You've never heard me in like
a jazz.
This is so cool.
Yeah, YouTube, TikTok, yeah, man.
I love it.
He told me to hop on the flat with it.
Yes, guys, shoot me a follow on TikTok at I am Pierre Ellie 7. I'm currently banned on ZPL 509 till Saturday. Zachy on the sexy. Thank you. love Albino. Yeah, yeah, send me some money if you can.
You and Tish first.
Thank you, Nathan. What do you have to do to come jam here? Every Saturday, go to Tulsa. My God.
Thank you.
Sure. Thank you, guys. Hey, I need y'all's help. Are you going to sing one?
Thank you. One more.
What do y'all think?
One more.
Thank you all.
Oh, sick.
Yeah.
tuning in to the Honky Tonk School Monday morning meeting. I'll see you guys next time. Follow me on TikTok, IMPLE7 if you haven't. This concludes this session this morning. Shout out to Uncle John, shout out to Steve Smith, the whole Honky Tonk School. You guys have a good rest of your Monday evening. Bye, everybody.
I need everybody's help, please. Can you help me put the chairs back up on the thing? Thank you.
Sorry. Yes.
Bye, everybody. Yeah, have a good night. Yes, sir.